And at the same time, I'm scared that you're here. I get nervous around adults. I'm really scared of children, but adults make me nervous. So if I'm not, it's because you're scared of me. I have not counted tonight, but if everybody shows up that was supposed to show up, we have 34 children up here. And they are 34 of the most precious children I have ever known. So that won't make me proud. I am proud of our preschool girls. We don't have any boys in our preschool right now, so it's just all girls. But we have a little preschool choir that's going to join us for two songs also. And I'll try to remember to get out of your way so that you can see them. Because the only place to put them when it's their turn is just up here up front in front of the other kids. So I know you didn't want a picture. So I'll try to do my best that you don't get me in your picture. And if you take pictures, please don't take them of me. I don't like that at all. Let's see. I wanted to just kind of set the stage of what our play is about. You'll see that we're all dressed in black with a big white circle. They're supposed to be penguins. So my name is Penelope Gwynn, and I run Polar Pet Park. And these children are on a field trip with their teacher to celebrate the holidays. And that's where the adventure begins. So most of us are penguins, and some of us are normal people. But if you're wearing black with a white circle, you're a penguin. And if they have normal clothes, they are people. So I'm glad you're here, and I feel the need to pray. So if you'll bow your heads up. Lord, I thank you so much for blessing us with each other. And I thank you for blessing us with Parkview Baptist Church. What a great place to be. Lord, I thank you for my opportunity to be with these kids on a regular basis. We pray, Lord, for a clear message to be presented tonight. We believe that Christmas is black and white, that it is written on the pages of your word, and it is clear that it's Christmas that are honoring you. So Lord, tonight, the words that we say and the things that we see, may they all honor you. May you bring you glory. Our kids are cute, but you're better than all of them. We thank you, Lord, for the way you love. We love you, Lord. Amen.
scoped and gaming. I scared who knows what kind of germs floating around in this zoo.
Actually, this polar pit park is one of very few of its kind, so we should be loud and proud that we are among the fortunate few who get to experience it.
Ern will be fortunate if he never used the phrase loud and proud again.
I know this field trip is supposed to be a big holiday party, but why can't we just have a regular Christmas party at school, like with presents and a big tree?
We can't do that, Paula. Don't you know I'm probably allergic to anything evergreen?
QBR549 guide on political correctness, it's no longer to have Christmas parties in public.
So who's to miss it?
But what guide? How do you know stuff like that?
It's just how I roll.
So who's the Mr. Killjoy sitting around making up dumb rules like that?
Oh, that reminds me. I put my Joy dishwashing blender so you can wash whatever plates and utensils that you were sticking on today. You can never be too careful.
That was so relieved.
So what if I should just ask Mr. Joy if we can have a Christmas party? Since I'm her favorite, might as well be me.
Correction, Paula. Since I am the one with the straight average, I am pretty certain. I hold the title of teacher's pet.
Whatever, honey.
Students, I would like you all to meet the general manager of Polar Pet Park.
Unbleached natural organic cane sugar.
teeth is sadder than what I had than when I had to leave my Portuguese people work in South America when I was such a baby little baby.
Yeah. From the whitest dress, I would say this one is a girl, and she's definitely trying to talk to us.
On the contrary, Miss Plateau, they are able to communicate using a variety of different sounds.
Well, there's no way that could just say Christmas.
That's all.
Yeah, totally missing the point. We definitely scared Willow's what Christmas is all about.
You're right. It's not just another holiday. It's a holy day, and it's not about the stuff. It's about Jesus.
Thank you.
time, but Christmas is different. No matter what other people could want to celebrate, Christmas is about Christ and remembering to honor him for all he's done for us. Children, God knows exactly what we need on this earth. He's given us everything we need. He gave us life, family, friends, food, clothing, a home, everything we need. He knew we needed Jesus, so he sent him to earth to show us what real love is all about. He said he'd be here to save us. Why not just
can show her how to trust him and not worry so much about everything. I really like how Mom uses an example, maybe both uses an example of us. We know how to love this. He promises to always take care of us. You know, listening to the Christmas story makes me wonder what it might have been like to be there in the stable that night Jesus was born. I love it because there were angels, humans, and animals, all God's creation, celebrating the birth of this son together.
I wonder what they all said.
Well, look at here. You're fine with listening. You're always so focused on your snacks that you never listen to anything we're saying.
Yeah, I know.
I wonder why I wouldn't sit standing by your manger bed. They always try to sneak up on us.
Sneak up? Ah, really
too.
Well, it makes me super sad that we've never talked to you about any of this before. Abby, you're one of my best friends, and I had no idea you didn't know anything about Jesus.
It's okay.
No, it's not okay. As your BFF, I should have already told you this. Jesus came to earth to give his life for you. He loves you, and I want you to know all about him because I love you. We all love you, Abby.
I know Jackie gets crazy all the time because I worry about things so much.
That's just it. When you choose to live your life for Jesus, you don't have to worry about anything anymore. There's a Bible verse that my mom always says, turn your worries up to the Lord because he cares for you.
You might want to hear a plaque or something with that on it.
Ernie.
Abby knows I'm only kidding. That's just my love language.
Yeah, I got your love language.
If you weren't teasing me, then I don't think that you were mad at me.
Jesus wants to be your best friend. Jesus wants to be your best friend. So are you cool with me telling you some more about
it? Sure.
Well, you heard the first part of the story a while ago about him coming to earth and being born in a manger.
When he grew up, he traveled around making miracles and teaching people God's word.
That was his love language.
Yeah, he's love.
Perfect love.
Jesus gave his life for us. The people who didn't understand who he was killed him, tortured him, nailed him to the cross, and let him hang there until he died. He could have stopped them, but he didn't because he loves us.
Why would he do that for us?
Because we mess up. Because we're sinners. Well, in the Bible, there always had to be some kind of payment for a man's sin. People use animals as a sacrifice to pay for their sin.
He It sounds confusing, but the closer you get to him, the more he helps you understand it all.
It's all becoming black and white to you.
I promise you, Abby, it's the most awesome way to live your life.
So do we pray?
Yes, come on, you guys.
What are you doing?
I think Jesus already changed you because you got dirt on you and you didn't freak out.
I didn't even think about that.
Story, so we better go rescue her.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah, that's